Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello student, how are you today? Fully you are healthy and ready to learn. Before we start our lesson today, sebelum kita mulai pelajaran hari ini, let's pray before study. Mari kita awali dengan doa sebelum belajar. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Raditu billahi rabba wa bil islami dina wa bi muhammadin nabiyya wa rasula. Rabbi zidni ilma warzuqni fahma waj'alni minas solihin. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Okay student, today we are going to learn lesson 3. It's a tidy living room. In this chapter, we are going to recognize the things in the living room and also learning about preposition of place, such as in, on, under, behind, between, and beside. Look, this is a living room, a tidy living room. Lihatlah, ini adalah ruang keluarga yang sangat rapi. Usually, a family spending time together in this living room. Biasanya, keluarga menghabiskan waktu bersama di ruang keluarga ini. Let's check what's inside the living room. Mari kita lihat apa saja yang ada di ruang keluarga ini. There are windows, big glass windows. Ada jendela-jendela, yaitu jendela kaca yang besar. There's a sofa and table. Ada juga sofa dan sebuah meja. There's a carpet under the sofa. Ada sebuah karpet di bawah sofa. There is also a painting hanging on the wall. Ada juga sebuah lukisan menggantung di dinding. There is a clock. Ada sebuah jam. There are lamps on the ceiling. Ada lampu-lampu di atap. There is a cupboard. Ada sebuah lemari. And there is a fireplace. Ada juga sebuah perapian dan tentu saja sebuah televisi, and of course a television. Now, let's learn to pronounce the words correctly. Sekarang mari kita belajar melafalkan kata-kata tersebut dengan benar. Repeat after me. Tirukan setelah ustazah ya. Sofa, sofa. Table, meja. Carpet, painting, lukisan. Clock, jam. Lamp, lampu. Fireplace, perapian. Cupboard, lemari. Television, televisi. Window, jendela. Other things we can see in the living room, for example, benda-benda lain yang bisa kita jumpai di ruang keluarga, contohnya chair, kursi, fan, kipas angin, mirror, cermin, bookshelf, rak buku, air conditioner, or pendingin ruangan, window, jendela, curtain, kelambu, and of course a family portrait, foto keluarga. Okay student, that's the things in the living room. Nah, anak-anak, itulah tadi benda-benda yang ada di ruang keluarga. Now, we are trying to learn to describe the living room. Nah, sekarang kita akan belajar mendeskripsikan ruang tamu. First, we know the things in the living room. And then, we also have to know the position of those things. Selanjutnya, kita juga harus tahu letak benda-benda tersebut. Preposition yang akan kita pelajari pada bab ini antara lain in, di dalam, on di atas, under di bawah, behind di belakang, in front of di depan, between di antara, dan beside di samping.
The first preposition is in, di dalam. Perhatikan contoh berikut ini. The clothes are in the cupboard. Pakaian ada di dalam lemari. The ball is in the box. Bola ada di dalam kotak.
The second is on, di atas. There is a flower on the cupboard. Ada sebuah bunga di atas lemari. There is a clock on the cupboard. Ada sebuah jam di atas lemari. And there is a lamp on the cupboard. Ada sebuah lampu di atas lemari. The third, under, di bawah. The cat is under the table. Kucing ada di bawah meja. The cat is under the chair. Kucing ada di bawah kursi. The fourth is behind, di belakang. Look at the picture. The boy is behind the chair. Anak laki-laki di belakang kursi. The owl is behind the box. Burung hantu ada di belakang kotak. The next preposition is between, di antara. The boy is between the chairs. Anak laki-laki di antara kursi-kursi. The boy is between the boxes. The next one is beside, di samping. The boy is beside the chair. Anak laki-laki ada di samping kursi. The cat is beside the box. Kucing ada di samping kotak. The last is in front of, di depan. The cat is in front of the box. Kucing ada di depan kotak. Nah, itulah tadi beberapa preposition of place yang kita pelajari hari ini. Mari kita coba gunakan vocabulary yang kita telah pelajari dan juga preposition yang sudah kita pelajari juga untuk mendeskripsikan sebuah ruang tamu. Perhatikan contoh berikut ini ya.
My living room. This is my living room. There is a cupboard. There are flowers between the cupboard and the television. My television is on the small cupboard. There is a painting on the wall. There are books in the bookshelf. Well, students, this is the end of our lesson today. Baiklah anak-anak, kita telah sampai pada akhir pelajaran hari ini. Alhamdulillah, we have finished our today's lesson well. Alhamdulillah, kita telah menyelesaikan pelajaran hari ini dengan baik.
Today we learn about things in the living room and preposition of place. In, on, under, behind, between, and beside. Thank you for today. Happy watching and happy learning. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.